Can you hear that? That background noise? That can really mess up my audio. And this is what I've been dealing with here in the Gettin Junk Done Studio / office. Every time I come up here to film anything, especially during my live streams where there's no opportunity to adjust it in post. So this is what I need to fix. And I think upgrading my audio or fixing this background noise issue is going to be a big step up. Let's turn off the AC for a minute and have a short discussion about how I'm going to fix this. All right, I'm back. AC is off. Let me explain a little bit more. My office is, it's got to be less than 150 square feet. It's not big at all. It might be closer to 100 square feet. I haven't actually measured it, but I don't think it's 12 feet wide, so it's probably closer to 10. And same thing with the length as well. Anyway, I'm forced to have a window AC unit. We don't have central air in this house, and because of that, along with the location of the office being on the second floor, on the side of the house that faces the sun, the hottest time of the year and day, I'm forced to accept and just deal with the noise level coming out of this window AC. It's old, it's inefficient, the knobs have fallen off, I'm using a pair of pliers. It's time to upgrade. Now, sometimes I record these videos, like right now, with the AC off, and I'm starting to perspire just a little bit already, and that's quite embarrassing with my scalp the way it is. So I make these compromises at times with the AC on and in the video quality being reduced because of the audio and so on. And again, this is often even more challenging with live streams. So I decided to purchase a brand new AC unit, and it is a different design. So let me show you what we're talking about here. So this is the new unit that I purchased with my own money, not sponsored in any way. It is the SoleusAir 6000 BTU saddle window AC unit. I think I'm saying that right. SoleusAir. What drew me, or what I felt drawn about this, is that even the right way to say it? Why I felt compelled to buy this one is the unique design. I haven't really seen anything like this before. I'm used to the old blocky style that kind of blocks part of the window. You close the window down on top of it, and that's what holds it in place. This is of a different design where it actually sits over the sill like so, like you could see in the picture there. And that allows you to have more of the original view, and it actually separates some of the components to the outside, technically, according to the description, reducing some of the noise. And again, that's my biggest goal, is reducing the noise that comes into the mic during these recordings. So I'm hoping that once this gets delivered, I can install it and I can have a before and after sound quality. And I'm hoping not for a miracle, because I have expectations. I will probably still have a slight amount of background noise, but I'm hoping it's less than what I've been dealing with this old inefficient piece of garbage. So that's that. Back to sweating again. I got the delivery. It has been installed, and it is currently running right now. See if you can hear anything. Now, what I can tell you was installation was, I did it by myself, not a big deal. There's some foam blocks that are made to be cut to fit for the particular window that you're putting this in. So it's relatively easy, and I'm on the second floor, so I have to hold it out the window and drop it down over the sill. It wasn't that bad. It was pretty straightforward to do. There's some really nice instructions, pictures, and everything included in the package. And it works out pretty well. Now, it's still running, so I'm going to keep talking, but I'm going to explain something in a minute. We have this remote that comes with it. And currently, the AC is set to high. This is what it sounds like on high. It is way quieter than the other one. Now, I'm not sure how it's being picked up by the microphone, but from just sitting here, I notice a distinct, stark difference immediately. And the cool thing about this remote, it has an actual built-in sensor with the remote. So it tells you the temperature wherever the remote is. And then on the LED screen, I think it's LED, whatever. On the screen, on the front of the unit itself, it tells you what the temperature is based on that. And you can set it right? Whatever you want it to be. So I have it set at 62, and that's pretty cool. And my temperature at the moment is 81. So it's currently 81 degrees where this remote is, and I'm only a few feet away from the unit itself, just like I mentioned earlier. But so far, huge upgrade, and I noticed when I was taking the old one out that that was a 5,000 BTU unit. This is a 6,000 from 5,000. So it's an upgrade in that respect as well, which it should run quieter because it's designed to be quieter. It should run more efficiently because it's newer, and it's a heavier unit in the first place. So all around, this is a good upgrade, and I've only had it running for a few minutes. So I'm hoping that this perspiration goes away pretty quick. But that's the basic initial thoughts. I really like this unit so far, and I'll probably do a long-term review after I get going for a couple of weeks. One last note before I go away, that there is a drain port on the left-hand side of the unit. And I'm assuming from the condensation, this will kind of build up over time, and you might have to empty it. I haven't actually read the directions because, you know, I'm a dude. But the directions probably explain something along those lines, the manual. So it looks like it's high enough up off the ground where if you do need to drain it, you put a milk jug or a bucket or something like that right underneath, pull the plug out, it drains. Put the plug back in, you're good to go. And there's some sensors and things like that explaining when to change or clean out the filter. All that stuff, I am sure, is in the directions in the manual. Again, I didn't read them yet because I'm a dude. Now, again, the main goal of this is to come up with some way of cooling the office / studio that's quieter than the original AC. So we're going to go through some of the different sound levels. We'll do it without, with the old AC, and now with the new. Both set to high for maximum air noise. So for comparison's sake, this is what it sounds like, just room noise, no AC on at all. And this is what it sounds like with the old AC on high. This is what it sounds like with the new AC set to high. So there you go, everybody. This has been what I think a huge upgrade and will definitely serve me well. Now it's just longevity. I will report back in a few months, probably towards the end of the summer, explaining my experience over this current season. Anyway, there will be an Amazon affiliate link down below in the description, so please consider using that link if you're going to look into buying something like this. If you like this video, hit that thumbs up. Please comment down below, share this with a friend, and most importantly, subscribe. As always, I can be found on Twitter and Instagram at Gettin Junk Done. I have an edited video, which is what you're watching now, every Thursday about 10:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And I do a live stream with my beautiful wife, Tina, most Sunday nights, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Thanks for watching.